Hi, and a blessed day to you. I am Edwin Valles, your host for this podcast, Be Not Afraid, where we listen to the journeys of LGBT persons through their Catholic faith. No? So we are blessed not to have another episode with us. No? So in this particular episode, I will not be interviewing an LGBT person. No? So, but we will be interviewing an aspect of the journey of an LGBT person siguro that needs to be addressed, no? So, and we're talking about gender theory, no? So, gender ideology. So, si Pope Francis, marami na po siyang sinabing mga statements about and warning us about the dangers of gender ideology. So, pag-uusapan po natin ngayon yan in this episode, and we are blessed to have an esteemed guest, no, to guide us through our discussion on this sensitive but very important topic, no. So let me just introduce to you, so si Dr. Gabriel Archemedez Flores, no. So he's the Director of Planning and Linkages and the Dean of the Expanded Tertiary Education Equivalency and Accreditation Program and Continuous Professional Development of the University of Perpetual Health Delta System, no. So siya po ay educator and philosopher, no. So ang kanyang credentials po ay include doctorate in educational management from De La Salle University in Las Marinas, also licentiate in philosophy from the ecclesiastical faculties of the University of Santo Tomas, and also licentiate in sacred theology from the Pontifical Lateran University in Rome. No? So parang malalim po and very rich ang expertise ng ating guest. No? So let's all welcome si Dr. Gabriel Flores or si Doc Gab. Doc Gab, kindly greet our podcast viewers po.
Nako, thank you very much for that very generous introduction. I want to greet everyone, our listeners. Good evening, and to this dialogue, we call it. I remember our professors in school, particularly the Dominicans, when we have oral examinations. No? They said the conversation is supposedly colloquium salutis. It's a conversation of It's a conversation that saves or salvation. He says. At any rate, excited ako, Edwin, to engage the topic. Sabi mo na very very sensitive and but very very relevant because it touches the heart of someone who is dedicated, who wants to be dedicated and committed to education.
Tama po. So education the one. So pag-usapan po natin yung impact or yung effect ng gender theory or gender ideology in an educational system, no? So specifically po, we will focus on Catholic schools, no? So para po mag-guide yung ating discussion parang in this episode, no? So parang sisentro po kami dun sa dokumento na inisyo ng Congregation for Catholic Education, no? So meron pong opisina sa Rome, no, na in charge po sa pag-guide and direct ng mga Catholic schools, no. So ito nga po yung CCE, Catholic Congregation for Catholic Education. In 2019 po, it released a document, no, entitled Male and Female He Created Them, no. So medyo mahaba po yung dokumento na to. Dinidiscuss lang po talaga yung gender theory and gender ideology in a Catholic educational system. So both of us, si Doc Gab po at saka myself, no, so I'm a part-time faculty of a Catholic university as well, no. So we are both para engage in Catholic education. So yun. So I think both of our experiences, no, so syempre yung extensive experience in Doc Gab in my very few years of educational experience, so hopefully we'll be able to shed light on this document. Maganda po yung parang ang opening statement po ng document ng CCE, no, so sabi niya it is an educational crisis daw, no? So, parang ano, first paragraph, first sentence, sabi niya, there is an ongoing educational crisis, no? Especially in the field of affectivity and sexuality, no? So, sige po, parang Doc Gab, for the sake of our podcast viewers, how would you describe po this educational crisis, no, that's happening concerning the field of affectivity and sexuality, also known as gender theory?
Well, I'm going to look at it from a positive perspective, no? Na I'm going to see it as a challenge sa atin in order for us to pay attention to what's happening. in our education system. Alam mo, yung salitang crisis o crisis na sinasabi natin, it can be, if we return to the original meaning, no, ang ibig sabihin niya, we need to learn how to exercise prudence and judgment when it comes to things that are actually taking place in that particular sector. Ngayon, we speak of sexuality and affectivity, very, very important, because during this time na we are experiencing confusion and disorientation, kailangan ng guidance ng mga bata. Kailangan din, hindi lang ng mga bata, even teachers and administrators, in order for us to return kung anong ibig sabihin ng sexuality at affectivity from the vantage point of our faith, no, from the point of view of our faith. Kasi ang dami talagang mga bagay na nangyayari, hindi mo sukat akalain, no. Of course, crisis, because kita natin na while on one hand, kami yung mga administrator sa loob ng eskwelahan, Catholic schools, no, wanted to be open to everyone. Want to promote yung sinasabi nating an inclusive education. On the other hand, kailangan nilang i-maintain yung kanilang identity, considering not just their vision and mission and core values, but above all, the source and the foundation of that vision and mission and core values, yung sinasabi nating Christian faith. It's a crisis because sabihin natin, I want to cite yung sinabi ni Pope Francis, no? Well, on the one hand, sabi niya, it wants to open us to the different realities, calls our attention to what's taking place. On the other hand, may tendency yung proponents ng gender theory when it comes to education na maging isang unquestionable position siya, no, na pagka hindi mo sinunod, para bang ay teka muna, you are actually biased. So mayroon, sabihin natin, while on the one hand nandiyan yung call for dialogue and therefore recognition ng differences when it comes not only to the identity but even perspectives, pero kung minsan pagka hinawakan mo rito yung when you go to the different topics, kaya nga siguro education crisis, medyo nagkakaroon ng konting conflict. So education crisis kasi nakakaroon ng parabang conflictual and adversarial attitude, generate, sabihin natin, di magandang environment, not conducive for teaching and learning process.
Yeah. Tama po. Maganda po sinabi niyo, no, kasi parang you began your statement looking at it from the perspective of the students, no. So, karamihan naman ng Catholic schools yung mga bata, no. So to speak, no. So, nasa developmental formative stage sila, no. So, in fact, yung old school classification of mga teenagers, no. So, meron talagang nag-undergo ng identity crisis, no. So yung that's part of the natural development of human person. So kasi yung teenager, kinikilala niya yung sarili niyang identity para independent from his or her parents, no. So kasama, yes, na rin po dyan yung paglabas ng mga sexual attractions and sexual feelings, no, because the body is biologically, physiologically transforming, no. So nagkakaroon na po yung parang yun, menstruation for women, at parang lumalabas yung sexual desires, no. So while all this natural human formation and development are happening, iba-iba po yung sinasabi about who the person is, no, yung sino identity, no. So meron pong Christian sense of identity, meron din pong tinatawag na parang secular sense of identity, yung po yung gender theory, no. So and then maganda rin po na nabanggit niyo si Pope Francis, no? Kasi nga si Pope Francis is perceived and in fact is very inclusive, no, in his papacy, no. So yung kanyang approach, pero it is quite interesting to note na despite his inclusion in specifically for LGBT persons, he constantly warns against the danger of gender ideology, no. So in fact, kinote nung CC document yung statement ni Pope Francis, na sabi ni parang in the words of Pope Francis, ang gender theory daw denies the difference and reciprocity in nature of a man and a woman, no. So parang wala daw, parang independent na yung sex, biological sex with gender, no. So parang while it is good na magkaroon ng distinction, yung danger niya kasi is pinag-iba or separate yung gender at sex, no? So parang tama po ba, that's how you would describe yung crisis that is being offered? And siguro po, paano po siya, paki-explain lang po sa ating podcast viewers, bakit siya problematic in terms of our Christian faith, no? Bakit problematic yung paghinihiwalay mo yung biological sex at yung gender identity ng mga tao? So
medyo sensitibo talaga kasi separating the two concepts, very dangerous, because sabihin natin from the vantage point of gender theory, ang sabi nila, gender, yung sexuality, sex is actually associated with what is natural, no? And while sabihin natin gender is actually based on historical and cultural conditioning, it should actually be the option of the person. Option daw ito, nung sinasabi natin, pwede kong sabihin siguro, positive man mahirap in terminology na postmodern mentality, na ang emphasis is supposedly the freedom. And yung analysis ng tao, or analysis ng sexuality is being done only from the vantage point of sociology. So nakakalimutan natin yung existential truth na meron naman talagang lalaki at babae, no? Ngayon, asan yung danger dito, no? Asan yung danger dito? Alam natin from the vantage point of, I'm going to speak of the vantage point of Christian faith, no? Don't want to enter into if we say na ang tungkulin ng isang eskwelahan is to give total formation to the human person. Yung pagkakakilala natin sa human person cannot actually prescind from the teaching of the sacred scriptures and the sacred tradition, no? Do sa yung sinasabi nating sources ng ating pananampalataya. Ang danger diyan kasi, no, tatanggalin mo yung distinction between male and female. Option mo na ngayon, paano ka, sino ka? So, natural distinction between male and female relegated sa second position. Ang emphasis ngayon dito would be choice, which napakatindi, because it will be having malaking impact nito regarding yung appreciation ng pagkatao ng isang bata na lumalaki sa loob ng eskwela, yung pagiging isang lalaki niya at isang babae, at yung konsepto ng pamilya kung saan yung complementarity ng male and female, kasi tatanggalin niya ng kwan, ng gender theory, wala siyang difference, no? Ang mangyayari, it will actually put into crisis not only the proper appreciation ng sex ng individual identity ng isang tao, but above all yung konsepto ng pamilya, which will be having, sabihin natin, a great crisis. From education crisis we go to the family crisis, kung saan kailangan ng guidance ng lahat ng especially ng mga magulang in understanding and following yung mga bata na, sabihin natin, are actually being introduced, particularly naman Edwin, social media, no, ang tindi ng dating. At para bang pagka sinabing kailangan kang lumabas sa yung closet, they celebrate it, simply they celebrate it, no, para bang nagpakatotoo ka, sabi nga nila, nagpakatotoo ka. Pero alam mo, hindi lang dapat ito nagpapakatotoo, dapat nagpapakabuti ka, nagpapakabanal ka. That's our basis, no? So it's not only all about introducing and guiding people to what is true, and sa loob ng ating eskwelahan to what is true, and introducing them to the different methodologies, acquisition of certain skills, no? Bago sa lahat would be the values that are connected with our dignity as a human person, to the sanctity ng pamilya kung saan tayo nanggaling, lalo na sa ating mga Pilipino, napakahalaga nito.
Tama po. I hope. Yeah. So, siguro, follow up ko lang yung two points na mention nyo, no? So, i-highlight ko. You pick up, kasi yung isa po, parang you started off with freedom, no? So, yung follow up ko dyan, yung follow through ko will be my own experience, no? So, as a gay man, no? So, a gay man na Catholic, na who values his Catholic faith, no? So, totoo naman po, no? So, while, parang kumbaga, I hid in the closet, and parang journey ko yung pag-out ko as a gay man, no? So pag-embrace ko na identity ko of a gay man, And when I got into the point of outing myself, no, so accepting myself for my same-sex attraction, it was really a feeling of freedom and liberation. No? So I cannot deny that. No? So para ako na emancipate, no, kasi parang and at the time while my Catholic faith was important to me, I was just picking and choosing parts of the Catholic faith na I was parang happy with. Yung mga part na kagaya ng homosexuality na parang is against my freedom and liberation, medyo I set it aside, no? So for many years I felt free, I felt emancipated, pero what's mysterious about it is that despite that freedom and emancipation, I was also not happy, no? So parang the happiness that I was experiencing in embracing my gay identity was siguro temporal, no? Very temporal, no? So parang bakit feeling ko parang mayroong kulang pa, no? Or parang this is not it, no? So siguro yun, no? So parang in God's mysterious ways, no? So he makes me realize na siguro parang my choice is good, but it's not better, no? So maybe I'm not meant to be in full control of my choice, no? So na parang maybe the universe should not revolve around myself and my choice alone, no? So yun, so that's one, no? So yung about freedom. Yung second po, maganda yung point no, na parang kinonnect niyo yung educational crisis to a family crisis, no? So and this is actually what ito rin yung konteksto ng warning ni Pope Francis, no, yung gender ideology. Actually, yung warning niya is in the context na kinuot ng CCEs in the context of Amoris Laetitia, no, which is his apostolic, post-synodal apostolic exhortation na coming from the synod and the family. So, in his prophetic reading of the times, no, so alam niya na itong gender ideology, while it is an exercise of human freedom and liberation and expression, has really dangers in family. No? So, in the latter document, dinidescribe kasi ng parang binild up or parang dinescribe ng CCE document saan ba nagmula itong parang filosofiyang ito, no? About the human person is about freedom and individual choice, no? So na yung sex, yung biological nature natin is parang siguro primitive, no? So or basic or relegated to second place, no? So binabasa ko yung mga German synod documents, lumalabas yung mga language na yan, no? So ang primacy daw is the human person and free will and yung of love, no? So yun yung mga language na sinasabi niya, no? So and then parang it built up pa rin na sinabi dito na kinonnect ng CCE document na ito rin yung problema na because of this mentality, yung pamilya daw is purely contractual and voluntary, no? So nawawala na yung essence of family that is self-giving, no? So or parang yung complementarity of sexes, no? So na parang the man is a gift to the woman, the male is a gift to the female, and the female is a gift to the male, no? So what can you say about that po, Doc Gab?
Ang daming tema.
The telephone sa kasi freedom and family.
Alam mo yung mga salitang emancipation, yung sinasabi nating freedom, yung sinasabi nating realization. Can be understood in so many ways, no? Pero dahil we are it's a Christian conversation, no? It's a dialogue that we want to propagate sa loob ng educational institution. I would like to return do sa sinasabi nating konsepto ng emancipation from the vantage point of our Christian faith, core ng education process, core ng education process. We cannot speak of, alam mo talagang darating tayo do sa punto na nag-enjoy ka sa buhay mo. I remember a lot of saints, yung isa sa mga favorite ko, Saint Augustine.
Yeah, correct.
Nag-enjoy na mabuti yan, pero at one point nakita niya that it's all empty, no? So he pursues, sabihin natin, a different direction, no? I think through the help of Saint Ambrose, no, nung mga time na yon. But it's very, very important kasi when we speak of emancipation, yung tema ng freedom, napaka-appealing yan ngayon. Kailangan ka maging malaya, magpakalaya ka, sabihin natin lumabas ka diyan sa pinagtataguan mo para bang that's the equivalent of freedom. Instead, ang freedom should actually be associated with what is good. And good is not simply what you think is good, no? What you feel is good. There is a goodness sa buhay ng isang nananampalataya that cannot be dissociated do sa kanyang dignidad bilang isang tao at kay Kristo. Pundasyon ng goodness ng isang tao, basis ng emancipation and real freedom. Of course, Edwin, tama 'yung sinabi mo, no? Coming out of that experience, definitely nag-enjoy ka. Pero at one point, makikita mo that the enjoyment mayroong umpisa at may katapusan. Hindi lang umpisa at katapusan, even 'yung content niya. It's not going very temporary 'yung liberating ko, 'yung liberating experience. Eh. At one point sabi mo ay walang natira. Then I go for kasi ang iksilan pala ng 30 minutes na. Then we go to the yung sinasabi nating education crisis and family crisis, mahalaga. Kasi sabihin natin sabi may malaking temptation namin na nasa administration. Wait, teka muna. Kailangan hindi tayo kailangan sabi ko nga kanina at the start of our conversation. We need to promote an inclusive environment. Pero an inclusive environment that is open for dialogue, no? An inclusive environment that recognizes differences. So we need to actually promote yung ibig sabihin ng diversity. Pero diversity that should not be, ito in the words of si Pope Francis, ito sabi niya, no? Kumisan ang gender theory assert themselves, no? Yung proponents will be asserting themselves as absolute, unquestionable, dictating even yung sinasabi nating manner by which families should actually be educating their children. Teka muna. No? As you have actually that perspective, yung nanay at tatay sa loob ng pananampalataya nila have their perspective also. Dapat yung respeto should actually be mutual if you wanted to call it respect. That is from the vantage point of, sa point of view ng isang tao o isang nananampalataya that recognizes yung sinasabi nating dialogue mutual respect and mutual recognition nung pagkakaiba-iba natin, no? Hindi naman ibig sabihin, I might be respecting you, for example, Edwin, I can respect you as different, pero hindi a different person, pero hindi ibig sabihin lahat ng mga pinopropess mo na pananampalataya ideally at tatanggapin ko. Tingnan muna, that's where we need to learn how to exercise yung judgment. That's where we need to focus sa sinasabi natin education crisis. That's where our attention is actually being called by the Catholic Church. Na yung tema about sabihin natin about person free will about love. Ngayon everyone speaks of love. Everyone na kwan. I remember several occasions ay nagkasama sila no and we speak of the triumph of love. Teka mo, triumph of love, yung ba sakramento ng kasal na sinasabi natin. Isa sa mga epekto na hindi masyadong magandang epekto ng gender theory is they change the thing. Tanda natin na ang pamilya ay hindi siya product ng social contract. Ang pamilya has its own theological basis, Christological basis, no? Ecclesial basis. So, you return to the narrative ng Genesis 1:27, no? Yung libro ng Genesis, sabihin natin, yung kasal cannot be separated from this, sabihin natin, from this pronouncement, no? Let's try to create men according to our image, no? So, God created men, no? According to His image. Male and female, He created them. And that's the reason why the man, the person, the male person will actually leave his house and go to his wife. And the two will become
one flesh.
One flesh, no longer two, one flesh. May mga bagay na dapat tayong tutukan doon and napakahalaga when it comes to entering into dialogue and sabihin natin, conversing with someone who is actually an exponent ng gender theory. So that yung ating dialogo will be done out of respect. Balance, ano? Balance, hindi nag-exaggerate, hindi sinasabi yung mali ka o tama ka. Pero ito yung aming perspective. Napakahalaga nito, ha? Napakahalaga nito.
Pero so, yun nga, yeah. Doc Gab, kasi the impression, no, so siguro ako as an outsider, hindi po, I'm not really an outsider, no, so because I'm involved in ministry to LGBT persons. So ang nakikita kasi ng mga tao, most of the Catholic universities in the Philippines, no, so they parang siguro because of their university charter, no, they promote liberal education, no, so yon parang free the mind, free the heart, free the soul, no, so pero ang nangyari talaga actually, so in many universities parang masyadong pinupush or may bias yung gender theory, no, so I think if you look at their liberal arts program, yung composition of the faculty, even yung theology, no, so even yung religious studies faculty are composed talaga of mga parang are leaning towards liberal views, no, so which parang ang nangyari, even if Catholic University yung brand nila or Catholic yung name nila, no, so but in fact in reality within the institution yung gender theory ang pinopromote, no, so parang hindi nabibigyan ng as much attention yung Orthodox, no, so or what is siguro considered by the church to be yung parang true teaching when it comes to affectivity and sexuality, no, so and in most cases, as Pope Francis pointed out, in which you mentioned, they clamor, ginagawa nila itong mga parang programs ito for inclusion, pero when it comes to dialogue, they trump, no? So parang yung gender theory is the absolute truth, no? So kapag you're trying to engage and explain the Catholic faith, you are labeled as homophobic, no? So or ano, parang so parang on the one hand gusto nila inclusion, pero at the same time parang pag chine-challenge na yung ideas nila and parang na in being pointed out yung shaky foundations of the philosophy, no, so yung ideology parang they're very severe na and aggressive, no, so kaya po siya dinescribe na educational crisis, no, so parang wala talagang doon for dialogue in that way, no, so
yung salitang dialogue, babalikan ko yan, Edwin, no. Yung salitang dialogue, I remember a professor of mine when I was in my, I think, second year theology in Rome. Strongly, pinag-aaralan namin yung documents of Vatican II, particularly in, I think, that was a discussion on Nostra Aetate about interreligious dialogue. Ang sabi niya sa amin, no, is like this, my dear students, he's a monsignor, no? Who work as espiritus in Vatican II, sabi niya, we need to really promote interreligious dialogue, interfaith dialogue. No? But be careful. When you enter into dialogue, make sure that you know who you are. You know who you are because you dialogue on the basis of who you are. Medyo sabihin natin, medyo malalim yung pagkaka-elaborate, pero ang gusto niya sabihin, if you're going to dialogue with someone who exercises, say, for example, Buddhism, yung pananampalataya sa Buddhism, do not forget that you have your Catholic faith. and therefore, it's your Catholic faith entering into dialogue with Buddhist faith. No? So you know kung ano yung meron kasing commonality kayo, may common denominator kayo, pero matindi yung differences. Kasi may tendency nga naman na when you enter into dialogue at hindi ka marunong mag-appreciate ng identity mo as Katoliko, chances are, pag natapos yung dialogue, Buddhist ka na rin.
Tama po.
May ganyang tendency. So by analogy, no, by analogy or by similarity, if we enter into dialogue with our friends coming from from our friends who espouse, sabihin natin yung sinasabi nating gender theory, you need to know above all kung anong ibig sabihin ng gender theory, but do not forget about your values. Hindi naman ibig sabihin na merong kang differences regarding their opinion, hindi na tayo magkaibigan. Magkaibigan pa rin tayo, no? Pero huwag mong kakalimutan na I am a leader ng Catholic institution at ako ay may pinanghahawakang mga prinsipyo na sabihin natin, while on the one hand, sabihin natin, I need to actually promote inclusive education and innovative approach in terms of methodology when we speak of education, no? Educational, elaboration of, sabihin natin, curriculum in teaching and learning. While there is this thing, Huwag nating kakalimutan that we need to always return, not just to the core values that we have, not just to the vision and mission that we have, but kay Kristo mismo. Huwag nating kakalimutan na siya. Kasi later on, hindi naman siguro bigotry or homophobic tendency na ganito. No. We need to actually, kung hindi matanggap ng ating mga kaibigan yung ganong tipo ng perspective, eh, medyo may problema tayong malaki. That really crisis. Kung saan, we are supposed to be, sabihin natin, exercising good, sound judgment. At good, sound judgment, not only using our logic, but using our faith. Using our faith. No, the faith that enters into dialogue. Remember, the great, eh, bumabalik sa akin yung mga tao na ito, St. Thomas Aquinas, no, St. Justin, and then the same St. Augustine. They will always be telling that faith should actually be capable of seeking reason. No? Faith that seeks reason. No? And reason, but reason also that seeks faith. Huwag nating kakalimutan that every dialogue, every conversation, every orientation that we have inside our Catholic institution should actually depart from the teachings of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Tama to.
At kapag ka, while on the one hand, bukas naman tayo for dialogue eh. Pero hindi ibig sabihin, eh, andun lang tayo doon sa punto de vista na yon na, oy, kailangan nating igalang, and we need to have to be liberal. Okay, liberal, tama. Pero liberal should actually be understood from a positive Christian sense. Catholic sense.
Tama po. Yeah. And I think yun din. Yeah. And yun, and to your point po, na tama po yun, no? So in engaging in the dialogue with gender theory or gender ideology, the Catholic schools should not forget who they are, no? Yung Catholic faith nila, no? So, and siguro, parang on that note, their role as Catholic schools is to be a beacon of light, no? So in this conversation, kung confusing yung theory or based on my personal experience yung gender ideology does not really lead to true and deep and lasting happiness, no? So yung Catholic school should be the one to guide and to parang to be the beacon of light, no? So and siguro parang to end this parang conversation, maganda yun po yung kasi yung maikli lang, no? Pero anyway, yung one very important teaching parang of who we are as Catholic Christians, no? So na minention din ni Pope Francis, so kinote din siya ng CCE document, no? So nag-quote kasi siya from our Maris City sa paragraph 56, no? So yung paragraph 56, maganda yung pagka-explain ni Pope Francis. Sabi niya dito, let us not fall into the sin of trying to replace the Creator. We are creatures and not omnipotent, no? So creation is prior to us. So nauna yung pag-create, paglikha sa atin kesa yung pagka-become natin as maging tao, no? So yung pag-choices natin. And because creation is prior to us and must be received as a gift, no? So at the same time, we are called to protect our humanity, and this means in the first place accepting it and respecting it as it was created, no? So siguro yung parang to end this episode, siguro yun yung what Catholic schools ought to celebrate, no? Or ought to preach in this in this gender theory times, no? Na we are a gift, no? So parang how God created us is a gift, no? So everything about us is a gift, yung including yung biological sex natin, no? So wag natin kakalimutan yan. Si Pope John Paul II elaborated on this, no? Yung the gift of our sexuality, yung theology of the body niya. So for about 3 years, yun lang ang sermon niya, no? So and parang instead of Catholic schools parang championing gender ideologies, they should champion all these beautiful teachings, no? Yung the gift of the human person, including yung sexuality natin, no? So sige po, Doc Cab,
before we wrap up. Edwin, ano, since you're talking of the gift of the human person, yung sexuality natin, male and female, tandaan natin na our being male, I'm referring to the human body, male and female, no, sexuality. This is these are the channel by which we express yung ating human person. And we should not forget, therefore, na meron tong function. Yung iba hindi talaga nila mabigyan ng tamang pagpapahalaga. Ano bang ibig sabihin ng pagiging lalaki, pagiging babae? No? Kasi kumisang sabihin natin, led by a kind of feminism na adversary lang dating, para bang may gera na it's being waged. Alam ko na may problema in several countries, may problema ng proper valuing ng pagkababae ng isang tao o pagkalalaki ng isang tao. No, while there is this problem, abe, hindi naman lang 'yon ang nandiyan sa atin. Nandiyan din yung dignidad ng pagiging isang babae ay pagiging isang nanay, dignidad ng pagiging isang lalaki ay pagiging isang tatay. Yung mga bagay na yan, probably sa mga susunod na episodes natin.
Pwede natin
ituan, no?
Yes.
Kasi yung matindi yan.
Correct. So tama pa, yung parang yung susunod po na episode, pag-usapan po namin yung DocCab, yung kasi dalawa, bibiyakin namin yan, yung Catholic schools as a place for formation in truth, no? So yun yung episode 2, part 2 ng episode natin. And then yung part 3 po is Catholic schools as formation in love, no? So kasi nga, pinag-usapan natin affectivity, sexuality, no? Kailangan natin pag-usapan yung love, no? So I hope you will join us po in the parts 2 and 3, no? So as we continue this very lively and engaging discussion on Catholic schools and gender ideology. So in the meantime, no, so again, this is your host Edwin Valles, reminding you, no, so in the during these turbulent times, so kung magulong yung isip nyo, madilim, no, yung parang pinagdadaanan natin when it comes to our identity and parang gender, no, so pakinggan po natin deep in our hearts the loving words of Jesus Christ telling us, "Be not afraid, it is I."